sinking ships. What a timeless fascination they hold, eh? 100 souls, 200 souls, lost at sea in deadly storms. Then came scuba gear, and we were able to explore the wrecks ourselves. The fascination grew, and so unwanted ships were sunk to make more dive sites. Like this one, the Waitaku, whose actual scuttling in a New Zealand bay you're about to see. So, is this a good idea? Divers and the teeming fish say yes, but toxic chemicals leaching from such wrecks have led to some countries banning the practice. Well, can they be made clean enough before scuttling? Bitter differences of opinion on that. It does seem strange to intentionally drop 4,000 tons of scrap metal on a clean sea floor. Avoca Beach has got it all, or so the locals will tell you. Clean water, the best surf of anywhere. And the prettiest movie theatre, a rare single screen, in the whole of Australia.
You know, we are the premier surfing beach on the New South Wales coast. We always have waves. We have the Longboard Association, the Women in the Waves Association, board rider clubs always stage their contests here because we always have good surf.
Now, if anyone was thinking that a wreck would be a fine addition to all of this, they were very quiet about it. But round that headland there, the Skillion, at Terrigal, it's another story. Excitement has been building now for about 10 years. Terrigal has worked incredibly hard to get a ship to dive on. And now they have their ship, the Adelaide. And it's just days away from being ready. Today, Bob Deere's dive site is still saying that the ship will be sunk off Terrigal.
It's going to be placed just approximately 1.5 to 2 kilometres, just out there. Here we have the HMAS Adelaide. It's sitting in the front of Terrigal Haven here. This is the site where the artificial reef will actually become. The HMAS Adelaide will be sunk here probably in about 12 to 18 months.
The TV news was saying the same thing not so many months ago.
New South Wales officially took control of one of Australia's most famed warships today, so it can sink it. Next year it will be scuttled off Terrigal on the central coast at a cost of more than $6 million.
Avoca Beach felt lulled. That is, until the yellow buoy appeared, right smack off our beach, and nowhere near the Terrigal Haven.
So, how far out are we at the moment?
We're only 1.7 k's off the centre of the beach.
Yeah.
The boat will sit at a depth of 32 metres once it's settled.
Uh-huh.
So at low tide it'll only be 6 to 7 metres from the top of the surface of the water.
Wow. There have been other boats that are sunk as reefs around Australia, have they?
Yes, five other boats.
Five other boats.
Yes, but never as close as this.
Uh-huh.
As far as all our research has gone, we're the closest ever scuttled ship.
You're worried about what this could do to the sand on the bottom, huh? Because it's very shallow here.
Because there actually is interaction between the sand deposit and the beach.
The sand goes in from here to replenish our beach.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
So you fear that with that boat sitting here, that will interrupt that that movement of the sand backwards and forwards?
Yeah, movement of the sand, the currents, definitely. And it'll act as a groin stopping the sand going to and from. Especially in big seas, like sometimes in a huge surf, and the sand river from the rips come out this far, depositing sand and bringing it back in.
Yeah, I've seen that myself. Sand in the parking lot and around the surf club where no sand is supposed to be.
So we didn't feel that the REF, the Review of Environmental Factors, looked into this deeply enough. Mm-hmm. And we would like it to be overseen by someone else to do further studies to prove to us and the community that it's not going to affect sand movement, because we're the only bay on within 140 kilometres that has this sand deposit. And it probably feeds this whole stretch.
Where?
Where?
Well, see, there is a boat there, and a bit to the right, in between.
Yeah, there.
Oh, there it is.
Yeah, some birds there.
The ship is directly in the path of the migrating whales. Right below the surface, it's got to be a real hazard to them.
Yeah. I think it's an unnecessary risk. That's my opinion. It's only a personal one.
Yeah.
Because I've lived here all my life, and it's a natural one.
Have you been a surfer?
Yes, I have, yeah. I was involved in a surf club and a fisherman.
Dennis knows too that when you tamper with the sea, things so easily go wrong. This rock pool, seemingly such a simple change, has been disastrous apparently.
Big mistake it was.
Big mistake.
And it created a rip on the point there.
Rip on the point, which has killed people. Des Redford said it was the worst rip he knows along the coast.
So it's pretty tricky tampering with the movement of the sea, isn't
Absolutely.
It?
Absolutely.
When a public meeting was called, Chairman Quentin Riley's expectations were not high.
What was your reaction?
Well, amazement. I mean, we set out 40 chairs here on the night.
Yeah.
And the place was just packed. It was
this
standing room
whole
only.
Whole space, huh?
It was just the fact that people wanted information. They wanted to know what they hadn't been told previously. And when you could have heard a pin drop for an hour and 10. That's how long
true.
It took to do that presentation.
Neil Robinson, lifetime surfer and ex-cop, claims that the decision was taken without consulting him or his mates in the surfing community.
It was here on the 29th of January this year.
Yeah.
A very few concerned Avoca Beach residents and board riders, young board riders, had a meeting with a lady from the Premier and Cabinet Department. After the introduction, she said, the vessel is going down on the 27th of March.
Of whatever you get people say.
Well, I was appalled.
Repeated three times it was. It was going down no matter what. My point of view is my own. I went to Quentin's meeting, neutral, but came away feeling that our identity is being stolen. After March 27th, we will be known not as the best surfing beach or the home of the greatest little movie theatre in the country, but as the graveyard of the Adelaide.